Hello and welcome to another multifaceted episode of Engineering 101, brought to you as always by your friends at Star Rapid. Let's say you've developed a new product design for a plastic part. You've gone over the engineering drawings carefully and you even have a nice prototype in hand so you know your part looks and performs the way you want it to. When you're satisfied with your design, the next step when preparing for regular volume production is to invest in a custom plastic injection mold tool. At this point, you need to consider a few options. Do you want a single cavity tool or a multi-cavity one? What's the difference, and how do you know which one is going to give you the best results? To help you decide, we offer this engineering overview of the pros and cons of each. First, we start with a single cavity. This type of injection mold tool is the easiest and fastest to make since there's less raw material that needs to be machined. Also, it's usually easier to design the other features of the mold, such as the gates and runners, ejector pin locations, cooling channels, sliders, etc. A few more advantages to consider. Single cavity tools are easier and less costly to repair should damage occur, as it sometimes does when a tool begins to wear out. And finally, single cavities work well for larger and more complex parts, especially those that don't need to mate with their mirror image, as they would with the two halves of a clamshell, for example. For these reasons, the tool by itself will be less expensive, but you need to weigh that relative cost savings against the fact that the tool can make only one part per cycle. Now, if you only want a small volume of parts, or you're slowly ramping up production as your market grows, then cycle time is not such a big deal, and therefore a single cavity might be the prudent choice. The money you save on tool making can instead be invested in other aspects of your business. However, remember that larger production volumes will need many more cycles, and this will add up to significantly higher production costs. Now we consider multi-cavity. If you have mirror image mating parts, it makes more sense to invest in a multi-cavity tool so that all of the mating parts can be molded at the same time, assuming the injection molding machine is large enough to hold it. Otherwise, you'll eventually need to invest in two or more separate tools, and that's not cost-effective. Multi-cavity tools are usually made with an even number of cavities whenever possible. Because you have equally distributed and balanced gate and runner designs with balanced injection pressures, then it's possible to ensure that all cavities fill simultaneously. More cavities per tool means more parts per cycle, a cost savings when making larger volumes. But that also means a more expensive tool that takes longer to prepare and will require more complex design input. Another major challenge with the multi-cavity tool is ensuring that it can fill completely before the gate shuts off. This leads to using a larger machine with a higher clamping pressure. Larger machines cost more to operate, so again, you have to balance the advantage of production efficiency against higher operational costs. In our experience, multi-cavity tools are absolutely worth the investment and will pay for themselves over large volumes. But how large are we talking about? It's impossible to give an exact figure, and much depends on the complexity of the part as well as your lead time. As a good rule of thumb, consider this solution when volumes go past 10,000 parts. We hope this engineering review helped you to clarify your choices when you develop your next project. Don't forget to like us, ring the bell, and consider subscribing. Thanks for joining, and we see you next episode for more Engineering 101.